टॉपिक वायरस। एट द लास्ट आई विल आस्क क्वेश्चन, सो लिसन केयरफुली। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो लिटिल बिट अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ बायोलॉजी विच मेक इंटरेस्ट इन टॉपिक। इन द बिगनिंग ऑफ बायोलॉजी टू साइंटिस्ट प्ले वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। वन इज डिमिट्री एवनस्काय, हु इज द फादर ऑफ बायोलॉजी। इन 18th सेंचुरी साइंटिस्ट हैड बीन ट्राइंग टू फाउंडेड द कोज ऑफ टोबैको डिजीज। In 1892, Avanaskai wants to know causing agent of tobacco plant disease. He just crushed the leaf of this tobacco plant and filtrated very small size of filter pore that retain the bacteria. But he showed that filtrate fluid had ability to cause infection to the healthy tobacco plant. Avanaskai think it may be due to some toxins of bacteria. Finally, he named it filtrate pathogen. In 1898, Martinus Beijerinck said that the filtrate pathogen grow only inside the cell, so this is not a toxin, and he named this Contagium vivum fluid, which is a Latin term, and meaning of this term is liquid form of living pathogen. As venom is also in liquid form, thus Martinus reintroduced a term called virus, which means venom or poison. Later known biologists named Stanley proved that they are not living organism, but they are in particle form and grow only inside a cell. So this is a brief history of our topic viruses. Now we conclude that virus meaning is venom, which is a Latin word. Remember, this is very important. And the bacteria size in micron while the virus is in nanometer. So it is very smaller than the bacteria. Now what is virus? First of all, they are obligate intracellular. Obligate meaning is compulsory and intracellular inside the cell. So virus need a compulsory a cell to grow or replicate. They contain only one type of nucleic acid. Either it is DNA or RNA, never both. Remind, this is also very important. So the virus does not contain any enzyme for the synthesis of protein and nucleic acid. They fully depend on their host for their life cycle, and they are that's why called as intracellular obligates. I previously told in the video they are filtered from the filter. That's why it is also called filtrable particle. They are multiply with not a simple binary fission like bacteria. They require a complex multiplication process. And this is all about the very important point about virus. Keep in mind. Now virus is the intermediate between the living and non-living because they just like dead particle when they are outside living being or in the host they become as a life. Viruses are very small, seen under light microscope, so also called as ultramicroscopic particles. Larger virus can be seen with the light microscope, such as pox virus. One reminding thing is that smallpox, small means small, but this pox is a large in size, about 300 nanometer. And smallest virus is our parvovirus, which is 200 nanometer. Please remind, this is very important. Now look at this picture structure of virus. The innermost is a single or double-stranded DNA or RNA virus, never both. In the middle layer, we have a covering of this nuclear material, which is known as capsid. So basically, it protects the genetic material from the destruction of various enzymes such as nucleases. Combination of this nucleic acid plus our capsid in combined form called as a nucleocapsid. This capsid chemically composed of polypeptide molecules and subunit of capsid is capsomers. This is also very important. So based on morphology symmetrical of capsid, they are divided into three types such as cubical, helical or complex form. In the cubical form, typical example is icosahedral. It is composed of 20 equilateral triangle. Please remind, this is very important for BSc level students. In helical, we have a spiral form of genetic material. एंड इन केस ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स इट डज नॉट कॉन्टेन एनी क्यूबिकल और एनी हेलिकल, इट इज कॉम्प्लेक्स नेचर, वी डिस्कस इन लेटर. सो द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर इज एनवलॉप. दिस इज प्रेजेंट नॉट एवरी वायरस एंड बेस्ड ऑन वेदर द वायरस कॉन्टेन एनवलॉप और नॉन एनवलॉप, दे डिवाइड इन टू एनवलॉप एंड नॉन एनवलॉप वायरसेस. केमिकली एनवलॉप इज लाइपोप्रोटीन नेचर. The lipoprotein of lipid derived from the host cell. This is also very important. That envelope is made up from the host cell membrane. The envelope contains spikes-like structure. This is called as a papillomers, and it's chemically composed of glycoprotein, which are the subunit of envelope. Papillomer is antigenic in nature. In previous lecture, I've discussed already that antigenic meaning any antigen who have capability or ability to induce our immune system to make antibody. The papillomer may be different types such as triangular shape, umbrella shape, mushroom shape, etc. Commonly, virus not having any enzyme for their vital energy process or for viral component synthesis, but some may also have enzymes such as transcriptase in retroviruses. So finally, not based on capsid but overall shape of our viruses may be different types, such as in case of plant we have mostly spherical. Please remind, this is also very important, come mostly in the MCQ in the exam, that rabies virus having a bullet shape, tobacco virus having a rod shape, and filamentous shape present in Ebola virus. Now we have a classification of virus depend upon the nucleic acid they contain. Basically, we have a two types of nucleic acid. One is DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, one is RNA. And the virus contain DNA called DNA viruses. And one interesting thing is that DNA virus is only six family in code to reminding, that is A3P2H. Again, listen, A3P 2H. A denotes to adenoviridae, 3P poxviridae, parvoviridae, papovaviridae. Another we have a 2H hepatinaviridae, herpesviridae. Rest of all are RNA family, and the virus contain RNA, they called as RNA viruses. They are 13 mainly, and common example you can see in Orthomyxoviridae, Flaviviridae, Togaviridae. So at the BSc level or in diploma level, it necessary we have to remind at least six DNA families. Now we have other classification based on replication mechanism of virus. They are divided into six category, which is given by Baltimore and commonly called as a Baltimore classification. In this we have a double stranded DNA, single stranded DNA, double stranded RNA. Now rest of three is single stranded RNA with positive strand, single stranded RNA with negative strand, single stranded RNA with association of some enzyme such as reverse transcriptase in retrovirus. Resistance. Majority of viruses are heat labile. At 56 degrees Celsius, virus kill in 1 second. At 37 degrees Celsius, virus kill in 1 minute. And if you keep the virus for long term storage, so we have to store it at minus 70 degrees Celsius. It also inactivated with sunlight, UV rays, ionizing radiation. Remind, this is very important. They are resistant to antibiotics. There is no role of antibiotic to kill the viruses. Now we have a viral multiplication. Six step for viral multiplication. First one is attachment of virus to the host with the help of host receptor. Another, penetration or enter into inside the cell. In this case, envelope fuse with the host cell membrane. Third one is uncoating or opening of capsid which contain a genetic material. Now fourth one is replication, बाय यूजिंग होस्ट न्यूक्लिक एसिड लाइक हाईजैकिंग द सेल एंड मेक देयर ऑन प्रोटीन सच एज वायरल प्रोटीन फॉर कैप्सिड एंड सिंथेसिस ऑफ न्यूक्लिक एसिड फॉर न्यू वायरसेस सेव दिस बाल्टीमोर क्लासिफिकेशन विच आई ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इज कम एट दिस लेवल. फिफ्थ वन इज असेंबली विच इज ज्वाइनिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ वायरस टू मेक अ मेच्योर और इन्फेक्शियस स्टेज ऑफ वायरस. फाइनली वी हैव अ लास्ट स्टेज विच इज रिलीज एंड इन दिस केस वायरसेज आर रिलीज फ्रॉम द सेल बाय टू प्रोसेस. वन इज बर्डिंग अनदर इज साइटोलाइसिस. इन केस ऑफ साइटोलाइसिस एज नेम सजेस्ट सेल आर ब्रस्ट और लाइस एंड दिस वायरस कम आउट ऑफ द सेल. टिपिकल फीचर इज दैट दिस डज नॉट कंटेन एनवेलप. वाइल इन केस ऑफ बर्डिंग वायरस कम फ्रॉम सेल एंड दे कंटेन एनवेलप बाय द होस्ट सेल मेम्ब्रेन. नाउ वी हैव सम अदर टर्म्स विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सच एज बैक्टीरियोफेज. सो बैक्टीरियोफेज इज अ वायरस विच इन्फेक्ट द बैक्टीरिया. अनदर वी हैव वायरोइड्स. द टर्म इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय डिनर एंड वायरोइड्स आर बेसिकली फ्री फ्रॉम प्रोटीन्स एंड इट इज लो मॉलिक्यूलर वेट RNA. It is resistant to heat. If you remind that viruses or virus are very sensitive to heat, while the viroids are resistant to heat, and it mainly cause disease to the plant. Another we have prions. Now P of prions, I am just telling a mnemonic to remind that P of prions mean protein. So prions basically contain protein and but it does not contain a nucleic acid. So this is a difference. Now we having a conclusion of all this topic, and this is the difference between virus and bacteria. First of all, according to size of virus is very small, which is 0.1 to 0.4 micron, that is 10 to 400 nanometer, while bacteria size is relatively large than the virus, which is 1 to 10 micron. You can see the difference. Another, based on nucleic acid, virus contain only one type of nucleic acid, either DNA or RNA, never both, while the bacteria contain both the nucleic acid, DNA as well as RNA. In case of cellular organelles, virus do not contain any cellular organelles such as mitochondria, ribosome, etc. While the bacteria contain cell organelles such as I discussed in the previous lecture, you can see in description the video, such as flagella, pili and mitochondria. Activeness, while it's only active inside the cell, that's why they called as obligate intracellular. Outside the cell, they are non-living being. While bacteria active both inside the cell or outside the host cell. Another we have enzyme. So virus does not contain any enzyme that make necessary for their life, while the bacteria have enzymes such as DNA, urease, etc. Cultivation. Virus cannot be cultured in the routine media such as Meconcus blood agar, while they are grow strictly in intracellular, and they are cultivated by these techniques such as animal inoculation, embryonated egg inoculation, tissue culture. While the bacteria can culture on routine media such as blood agar, chocolate agar or other nutrients agar medium. Sensitivity. Basically antibiotic act on cell membrane or enzyme present on bacteria. While the virus does not contain any cell membrane, not any enzyme, so there is no any action of medicine or disinfectant against the virus. Bacteria are sensitive to this medicine because they attack directly on the enzyme present on the bacteria. And another sensitivity toward the heat. So viruses are very highly sensitive to the heat and get inactivated within a minute, 37 degrees Celsius. Bacteria resistant to heat. Some bacteria spores even resistant to the boiling water. You can imagine. विजिबिलिटी, वायरस जनरली नॉट सीन विद द ऑर्डिनरी माइक्रोस्कोप सच एज लाइट माइक्रोस्कोप, दे आर ऑब्जर्व ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोप. इन केस ऑफ बैक्टीरिया दे आर विजिबल विद द हेल्प ऑफ लाइट माइक्रोस्कोप. दिस डिफरेंस इज बेसिकली कंक्लूजन ऑफ प्रीवियस एंड दिस टॉपिक. नाउ वी हैव अ क्वेश्चन इज दैट व्हाट इज द सब यूनिट ऑफ कैप्सिड. अनदर वन, व्हाट इज द सब यूनिट ऑफ एनवेलोप. आई होप यू लाइक दिस. शेयर, सब्सक्राइब, लाइक द चैनल. थैंक यू.